All right, so let's say we want to dock two spacecraft together in orbit.
Hi. Yeah, are those rubber ducks?
Yeah, it's my visual aid, right? I want to kind of show them visually how spacecraft dock.
That's what we have on this channel for visual aids is rubber ducks. You don't have like a graphic animation you could show them?
Yeah, I could. I mean, kind of wanted to show something tangible though. But no, I got it. We can use, this will be better. All right. Say we want to dock two objects.
Seriously? Water bottles?
Well, yeah, it's got its own docking port here. You docking port, coming.
Could you, for 2 minutes, try to be a professional?
Okay. I got it. You're gonna like this one.
Really? Because I feel like you're about to show me the worst one.
No, for real. I put a lot of time into it. I think it's good. You're gonna like it. Here, let me. All right. Say we're gonna dock our Crew Dragon to the space station.
A potato? What's wrong with you?
Yes.
How are people supposed to take this channel seriously? You can't be professional for 2 minutes, you know, let alone make a 2 minute long video.
Just say 2 minute Tuesday. It's not a 2 minute long video.
It's fine. It's okay.
Under these conditions, you use whatever you want.
No, they're gonna like it. They're gonna like it. I think they'll like it.
That was kind of cool. It's a little Crew Dragon potato.
Go for deploy. Other speed, lift to the right roll. Contact right. The Eagle has landed.
Hey friend, Tori here from Overlook Horizon, and welcome back to 2 Minute Tuesday, where I cover a topic briefly for about 2 minutes. It's never 2 minutes, but whatever, that's not important. Consider subscribing if you want to see more. All right, now let's get serious and talk about orbital rendezvous and docking, but before we do, let's put 2 minutes on the clock. Never mind, let's just dive right in. If you caught our last episode, you learned how to get to orbit and circularize your orbit. Now, we're going to use Kerbal Space Program again to pick up where we left off, with two spacecraft in orbit aiming to meet and dock in space. Now, there are way more complicated ways to do this, but we're going to keep it pretty simple. Let's set the stage. We have two objects, a satellite in a higher 200 kilometer circular orbit, which will be our passive docking target. You can think of it like the International Space Station. Then we have a modified Gemini spacecraft in a lower 86 kilometer circular orbit. This is going to be our active chaser. The first challenge in orbital rendezvous is the chase. The spacecraft in the lower orbit will travel faster than the one in the higher orbit due to orbital mechanics. But why is that? Well, it's because of a principle called Kepler's laws of planetary motion. Essentially, the closer an object is to the planet, the stronger the gravitational pull it experiences, which means that it needs to travel faster to counteract this pull and stay in orbit. So our spacecraft in the lower orbit is moving faster than the satellite in the higher orbit. As the chaser gets close to the target, we then perform a Hohmann transfer to move from the lower orbit to the higher orbit. Now, a Hohmann transfer is a two-part maneuver used to transfer between two orbits. First, we perform a prograde burn, which means we fire our engines in the direction that we're already traveling to increase our speed. This raises our apogee, or apoapsis, which is the highest point in our orbit, to the altitude of the target's orbit. Then, we coast. Once we reach our new higher orbit at the apogee, we need to circularize our orbit again. This means performing another prograde burn at the apogee. This will raise our perigee and set our speed for the new circular orbit. Circularizing an orbit is important because it ensures that we're in a stable, predictable path around the Earth. If we don't circularize, our orbit will remain elliptical or oval-shaped, which can complicate the rendezvous process. Now that we're in the same orbit and in the same general vicinity as our satellite, we need to line up for docking. This involves fine-tuning our approach using small burns to adjust our speed and direction. Now, a common misconception in space is that many people think you can just steer straight at an object in space like you're driving a car. But in space, it's all about relative speed and relative motion. Remember, neither object is stationary, so to meet up, our relative speeds and motions need to match. If you aim directly at your target and just burn towards it, you might miss it because both objects are moving along curved paths that are dictated by their orbits. Here's an example of what can go wrong if our approach isn't precise. We might end up just flying right past our target. This kind of highlights the importance of careful planning and execution in orbital maneuvers. So instead of flying straight at the target, we use prograde and retrograde burns to adjust our speed relative to the target. We also use thrust translation to move sideways or up and down without drastically changing our orbit. This allows us to align with the docking port and dock successfully. Okay, now let's add another layer of complexity. I have a second Gemini spacecraft that's also in a lower 86 kilometer circular orbit, but this time with a 52 degree inclination. Inclination is the tilt of the orbit's plane relative to the equator. To dock with that same satellite target, we need to align our orbits in the same plane. We can't be tilted differently. Usually this is done at launch time, but in this case, we messed it up, and now we need to adjust it in space. This is where the ascending and descending nodes come into play. The ascending node is where the spacecraft crosses the equator from south to north, and the descending node is where it crosses from north to south. We perform engine burns in the normal or anti-normal direction at these nodes to adjust our inclination. The normal direction is perpendicular to our orbital plane in the direction of our motion, while anti-normal is perpendicular in the opposite direction. Now, let's talk about the realities of these burns. First, notice how much energy we need to expend to perform this maneuver. It's a lot, way more than if we just entered the correct orbital plane in the first place. Our fuel is not unlimited, so this is why we don't see big changes like this very often. Secondly, the spacecraft is still moving while these operations are taking place, and engine burns aren't instantaneous. In my animation, our engines aren't actually powerful enough to make the change in one go. So we burn for a while, we end up passing the ascending node, then we have to coast to the descending node to perform another burn. This shows how orbital adjustments are a continuous process and require some precise timing. Okay, after aligning our orbits, I have now ended up in an elliptical orbit. So to fix this, I have to perform two burns to circularize our orbit at a lower altitude before starting the chase. Once our orbit is circularized, then the chase begins. Next, we perform that Hohmann transfer maneuver to raise our orbit and match the target's altitude and circularize. Then we can prepare for docking. As we approach, we again use prograde and retrograde burns to fine-tune our speed. We use thrust translation to adjust our position. During this phase, we also rely on our instruments to guide us using target and anti-target markers. The target marker shows the direction toward our docking target, while the anti-target shows the opposite. With careful maneuvering and precise burns, we achieve docking once again. All right, now let's take a look at a real-world example. The Crew Dragon, docking with the International Space Station. As you can see, the approach is very slow and deliberate, with continuous adjustments using thrusters to ensure a smooth and safe docking. And here's a demonstration from the SpaceX docking simulator. This is a cool tool similar to what astronauts use to practice precise maneuvers required for docking. You can try it out too. I'll put a link in the description below. It emphasizes the importance of using thrusters for very fine adjustments and maintaining a slow, controlled approach. Patience is key here. So, we covered a lot here today, but hopefully you have a new fond appreciation for how complicated orbital rendezvous and docking can be. If you like this video and maybe you learned something new, hit that like button. Consider subscribing. I'll try to do more of these. This one wasn't even close to 2 minutes. Maybe we should do 10 Minute Tuesday. All right, that's gonna do it for me. My name's Tory. This is Overlook Horizon. I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye. Here's a view from the Crew Dragons. The Crew Dragons. What is the Crew Dragon? What am I saying? I don't even know what I'm trying to say.